Humberto received an invite to the party house gathering from his friend Joaquin. Wanting to get away from the recent drama where Isabella was concerned, he gratefully accepted the invitation. Humberto asked who else would be showing up. Joaquin told him all the spin masters and powerhouse would be there. Knowing Kaliani would be there made him even more excited about the outing. He knocked on Kaliani's bedroom door to ask her if she wanted to carpool. Kaliani was in her room getting ready for her night out with the spin masters, nervous about meeting another club in the area, but she urgently needed a break from Isabella's accusations regarding her series of unfortunate events the week prior. Kaliani had held herself up in her room most of the week and only left her safe haven to cook meals, fix the plumbing, and clean house. Her thoughts were interrupted by a knock at her bedroom's door, but before she could answer, the spectacular light enveloped her and transported her to the blue dressing room. Kaliani was even more nervous than she was on her first visit. "What's wrong, Kaliani?" Kaliani answered that she had a suspicion that Isabella was suffering maladies since their acquaintance in the dressing room a few weeks prior. Kaliani pleaded with her new friend not to perform any more transformations on her. She didn't want to go through any more changes because she didn't want to burden Isabella. Her fairy cast mother confirmed her realization. "This curse is not yours to control. The curse belongs to the originator, and Isabella is the source of the dark magic. It's a matter of physics, Kali," explained her new friend. With that, Kaliani's body morphed into a silhouette of perfection. Her knobby knees didn't knob, and her skeletal weight became healthy. She couldn't help but smile in earnest. "Don't thank me, my sweet. This is all you're doing. Keep up the amazing progress, and I'll see you soon." When she was teleported back to her room, Humberto was still knocking on her door, determined to get Kali to answer. "Coming!" When she opened her door and stepped into her father's study, Humberto immediately noticed her previous skeletal weight was replaced with the most beautiful figure he had ever witnessed on another human form. He was captivated, mute, and his heart performed weird gymnastics within his chest.
"What is it, Humberto?"
Yes, So, Joaquin said you guys were meeting at the party house tonight. I was invited too. Do you want to go together?"
"Yes, sure. I'll be ready in a minute. I'll meet you at the car."
When the room door closed behind Kaliani, Humberto forced himself to sit down for a second and regroup. His feelings were all over the place, and he needed to take control as soon as possible before he made a fool of himself. Later that evening, Kaliani and Humberto both enjoyed meeting the free-spirited group that made up the Party House Club. They were fun, lively, and really knew how to host a party. Their new friends consisted of Ava, who was loud and rather snobby, but had the most incredible stories to share with the group. Paolo, the ruggedly handsome playboy whom Humberto knew from his powerhouse club. And last but not least, Jade, the captivating Portuguese beauty that had recently become involved with a new guy in town named Alex. They both worked at Simtopia Enterprises, which ironically belonged to Kaliani's father. But she didn't want to ruin the festivities by talking about her dysfunctional family. Kaliani offered to help make some popcorn as they all decided to watch a movie together. Humberto couldn't help but stare as she walked into the kitchen. Alex caught Humberto staring and felt a kindred spirit immediately. He mustered up the courage to pry and asked Humberto how long he and Kaliani were dating.
"Oh, we aren't, oh, forgive me. I just saw you staring and I figured, I mean, I..." "Don't worry about it, man. She and I are really good friends, but I'm dating her sister. That's, awkward."
"It's definitely complicated."
"Yeah, no doubt. I thought my relationship with Jade was complicated."
"I am sure many relationships start in the complex zone, my friend."
"I guess you have a point. I want to take my relationship with Jade to the next level, but I fear..." "I'm sorry, dude. I don't know why I'm sharing all this with you. I just met you. You must think I'm weird."
"No, not at all.
I'm the guy staring down his girlfriend's sister, remember? You have a point.
Meanwhile, in the kitchen, looks like our men are getting along very well, no?
Our men? No, I mean Umberto and I are just friends.
Really? I do not think you two are in the just friends category by the way he looks at you tonight.
No, besides, he's dating my sister.
That may complicate things, mal amor, but doesn't prevent the heart from desiring its truest of passions.
Oh, look! Popcorn is popped! Do you want a ball?
Kalyani fervently tried to change the topic of conversation. Miña querida, you are funny. Tell me something. What if he kissed you tonight? What would you do? Kalyani was so flustered by the question she dropped her bowl of popcorn. Do not worry about popcorn, Ualiadu. Tell me something. Have you ever kissed anyone before?
No. No, I can't say that I have.
Amig, I will be happy to help you in this area. Just stick with me and follow my lead. With that, Jade sashayed over to Alex and planted the wettest, hottest kiss on his mouth in front of all the party members. Kalyani couldn't help but smile. Her new friend was unrestricted, adventurous, and well-versed in the arts of woohoo. She could tell by the epic party kiss. Umberto couldn't help but envision that it was he and Kalyani together instead of Jade and Alex. Hello everyone, hope you all are super duper. For those of you that are new, welcome, I'm Virtually. Those of you that are coming back for more of Cursed Beauty Storyline, yay! Thank you so much for your continued support on this series. It is my baby for sure, and it means the world to me that you're so fond of it as well. Okay, I apologize for the long video story today, and because of the length, I'm just going to chat with you for a little bit. So sit back, relax, grab some tea or coffee, and let's talk about the collaborators on this episode and the direction of the story, okay? First collaborator, official girly simmer, as most of you know if you're following the story, is Kalyani's fairy cast mother. She is one of the top cast creators. Cass is Create a Sims. For those of you that are newer to the simming community, she is one of the top cast creators in the community as far as I'm concerned. And today I am just so honored that she has agreed to collaborate in this project. But true to her stellar talent, she performed a stunning job on Kalyani's body transformation in this episode. What I love about Kalyani's new silhouette is that it's not real skinny, but her curves are just on spot. Do check out her channel, which is in the description box below, for an exclusive and detailed look on her newest updates on Kali. And she's even mentioned that she has before and afters, so check it out. If you think this transformation so far has been cool, I can't wait for you guys. Well, I personally can't wait to see the final phase, which Official Girly Simmer has promised to help us out with as well. Now, on to the next collaborator, which is none other than Citizen Erased 14. You guys, I am so incredibly stoked about this collaboration of sorts. So here's the deal. Jade and Alex, in this most recent episode, are really stars in Citizen Erased 14's most current simlet called Ashes to Ashes. Citizen Erased 14's simlet is the very first I've ever read in all the years I've been playing The Sims, and I think I recall correctly that I sent her a message stating I was hooked. I spent an entire weekend catching up on her Dust to Dust story, and then kept up with the storyline all the way up to this point. I'm one of her biggest fans. As a matter of fact, she's the reason why I became bold enough to share my stories with the world. So imagine my joy when she gave me permission to share her main characters, which will be guest appearing for the remainder of Cursed Beauty. A bit more about Ashes to Ashes. It is a legacy challenge. That is all things epic. So I encourage you to check out Alex and Jade's stories so you can see what adventures these two Sims get themselves into in her story. But I would be remiss if I don't tell you that I highly encourage and recommend reading Dust
to Dust first, which is the preceding legacy story, also on fire. That way, you'll get a landscape of Alex and what he's about before you read his story. But completely up to you. It's just recommendation. On the topic of Ashes to Ashes, one of Cursed Beauty's characters may or may not make a guest appearance in her story. So stay tuned and do check out her blog. The link is down below. Now on the topic of this episode, I have to share some pictures with you. There you go. Those that are following Ashes to Ashes story and know and love Alex, he was a bit of a spitfire while I was setting up the video story. And I know it's completely out of character for him, but it is hilarious and I wanted to share. So let's redirect back to Cursed Beauty just for a spell. I had to do 5 different voices for this episode, so I was forced to learn how to play with a pitch manipulation on Audacity, which is an audio solution, a recording solution, and only does audio. It's so cool, and I'm mostly sad I haven't dabbled with it prior. So what I wanted to say is thank you so much for allowing me to be experimental with this saga. I think I've probably shaken things up with different styles of videos and pictures, and now audio. Your head is probably spinning, but the fact that you're letting me experiment with you is a joy for me, so thank you, thank you. As far as story progression is concerned, Umberto is in love with Caliani. It's not a secret, it's really obvious, but he hasn't verbally shared his feelings because, well, Isabella is a huge concern, and he hasn't really fully grasped that he's somewhat cursed himself. So that's something he has to work out before we can actually see these two together. I rather like that Caliani is just focusing on herself right now, and while we know she has the crush butterflies dancing in her stomach regarding Umberto, her main focus is herself, and that's just amazing to me. Please note that the upcoming chapters will be focusing more on the video story than actual gameplay. Well, because there's so much happening in these last 7 chapters. I know, only 7 chapters remaining to Kali's story, so I hope you guys don't mind. I am going to sign off for today. Thank you again so much. I know I say this in almost every episode, but your support with this story is so encouraging and so uplifting, and it really is the driving force for me to continue and really write storylines for you guys to keep you entertained, keep you laughing, keep you on your toes. Check out Official Girly Simmer's channel. Check out Citizens Erased Stories. You will not be disappointed. You guys take care, and I'll talk to you super, super soon. Ciao.